it was great to get a postcard from Prague inviting me to come visit one of my absolute favorite cities in Europe. Prague is known for its beauty and for its enduring strength. It was the city in Europe that survived the major destruction of the 20th century. Prague's center is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. And the city receives 4 million international visitors annually. It is the sixth most traveled to city in Europe. Sometimes you show up to a city as a traveler and you suddenly discover that something special is about to take place on the day you're going to be there. August 13th was the very first Prague Pride Parade. Since it was the first of its kind, the organizers weren't exactly sure whether or not people were actually going to show up, whether or not there'd be kinks in the system, and it was a little bit threatening to rain. About an hour prior to the parade, there was just a subtle touch of pomp and pleasure. The signals that something was about to happen were definitely here and there, but Náměstí Republiky was hardly a cavalcade of debaucherous sin. There were a couple photographers, some police, some security, and an atmosphere of relative calm. Across from the staging area, you wouldn't even have known anything was about to happen. It really was the most subdued beginning to a pride that I had ever seen. In my arms, tell you it's okay. Some individuals were very calmly handing out protest flyers, pro this, anti that, but doing so in a very subtle manner. Some of them, quite frankly, made no sense to me. In the interests of free speech and assembly, the neo-Nazi protesters were given a space to congregate, which is where a great number of reporters and looky-loos had also gathered. There, you can sort of just see them next to the contact lens store. Oh yeah, and of course there was this guy. I wanna feel that way every single day. When the parade actually started, there was nothing but warm feelings in the air. Everything seemed like it was on course. People lined up to watch what was going on. It was peaceful, it was exciting. It was a wonderful atmosphere, very uplifting, very encouraging. I think people were waiting for this enormous confrontation to occur when the pride met the protesters, but that's not at all what happened. Just like a sea of good feelings and tolerance, as the parade came towards this intersection, it washed over all of the hate and all of the negativity and all of the screaming, and there was nothing but people having a great time. All of the negativity was washed away by the people in the parade, and something amazing happened. And I swear to God, I did not doctor the footage on this. When the parade passed the intersection with the protesters, the clouds parted almost instantly, and full sun shined down right on the parade, and everything was illuminated, and everything was lit, and from then on it was an absolutely beautiful day for the rest of the week. The sun lit up this sign that said, "Human rights are my pride," and I got this amazingly intense warm feeling inside. I was amazed at how quickly it all changed. 10 people became 100, became 1,000. What seemed as if it would be a few revelers who had gathered in a square transformed into a European capital full of people. In the end, the parade was such an unbelievable success. And to just see all of the smiling faces, happy marchers, and people having just a really great time. I mean, that's what these things are designed for, so that people come together and have a really incredible time. The organizers of Pride had this amazing idea to have a party following the parade on Shooter's Island, which is right on the Vltava River in the center of Prague. And the views are fantastic. You can see the whole rest of the city which surrounds you. And it's a really awesome place to get together and just have a great time. When the parade was concluded, the island literally filled with people. They came pouring down the steps. I mean, just take a look. Expectations for Prague Pride were greatly exceeded in every possible measure. One of my own observations was that Prague Pride wasn't terribly commercialized. It was just a lot of people coming out to have a good time and marching and having pride in the fact that they were there. And I give the organizers and the participants a huge amount of credit for being a part of something that's going to be long-lasting and enduring for the city. There is absolutely no doubt in my mind that Prague Pride will continue into the future. The measure of these things is, did everyone have a good time? Did something positive come out of it? Will people look back and see these events and think, that was awesome. I am so glad I was there and that I was a part of it. I absolutely feel that way. I would look forward to going to it again.